Hello there and welcome to this video. So this is a number of different items that I have in front of me. You probably can't see them there, which I'll go through. So over my many years of working, you know, with seances, healing circles, etc., especially sitting for spirit in darkened spaces, I found that there's a number of different objects that have been, you know, very beneficial and easy. At the moment, my current lamp, which I put together using a typical wall dimmer, is over there, but I've set one up here as an extra so you can see. Now, this lamp comes from IKEA. I'm sure you've heard of IKEA before. I think it's a Swiss company, very big furniture store, and they still sell these type of lamps, but they don't sell the red anymore. However, you can get the plans to have a 3D printed top if you get the base. So the base you can still buy, and the actual lamp, and when you turn it on with the thunderbolt, the light switch basically, if you turn that on you can do so. But the cable I rewired myself and put in a wall dimmer. However, this one is just on an extension lead, and you can just dim it down and lighten it up as much as you like. So this is what we had originally put into on our setup, which was basically a plug, which this is English, so this goes into a socket or extension lead, and then the lamp plug goes onto this socket, and then it's a dimmer basically, so you can dim down the light. So that is that. It's important to work, you know, when you're working with ectoplasm, not to be using direct white light. So if you're sitting in light, that is light like I am, it's too much. So you need very little light as possible. Well, no light is best when you're working with ectoplasm and sitting. And when you're doing with like healing circles, home circles and trance is also better in darkened conditions, but it can also be done in semi-light and pitch black with the lights off. But when you're working with physical mediums and seances, you don't want any light at all. Any white light can disperse energy. So if you're having trouble having results and you're sitting with a light on, it doesn't always work. Not saying that happens to everybody, just a general rule of thumb. So with that, we also play music, which is a very important thing to do. And it should be songs that are, you know, popular and ones that the circle members enjoy listening to. And regardless if it's a home circle or seance, they need to be quite popular and famous songs that raise the energy. Now, you're not sitting just to always sing. And even if you don't know how to sing, then you don't have to sing. You can even hum or just, you know, you don't even have to be a good singer. It's just about giving that energy. And perhaps you'll probably find one day you know the words. So if you don't know the words, just hum with it and just give your energy. Important thing to do is also don't dance in your chair, because that can sometimes disperse energy, but just sitting and singing and just, yeah. Often, so what happens in a seance is that lights are completely off, so no light at all on, it's pitch black, it's so black, so dark that you can't even see a hand in front of your face. You can't see anything in the room. It's like having your eyes closed with a blindfold on, but with your eyes open in a completely darkened room. And often people don't realize how dark a room can get. It's pitch black. So for that reason, we play music. And what I found is that shuffle iPods work really well. You've probably seen these before or not, but this is a MP3 player by Apple. I'm not really a big Apple fan, but these work really good. On the back, I've put some Velcro, and on the little table I have over there, which that current red light is sat on, there's another bit of Velcro. So I just stick that on there, and I can just have my thumb on it ready, finger on it ready, just to control the music. So how I've done the music is a certain setup in a certain way on a playlist. And so on this dial, up is for volume up, and then the very bottom one is a volume down, and then just skip left, skip forward and skip backwards. It's very simple, and the sender button is for playing and pausing. I've also put a bit of blue tack on here. A bit of, you probably heard of blue tack, it's white tack actually, plasticine, to cover the indicator light because even that can be very bright and you might not think so. So that is protected on there so it doesn't give off any light. Then I have a 3.5mm jack which goes into here. And then this goes into a speaker. So I have a JBL speaker, which is still working really well today. This plugs in here from the iPod. And I've also put some duct tape with some indicators of red duct tape on here to show where the on button is and the volume. And also the bottom, there is a bit of duct tape to show where the lights up. The little LED lights show how full the battery is. So even things like that can be too much light. You'll be surprised. In pitch black, your eyes get used to it. And yeah, in the small bit of light is quite challenging. So that's the typical objects that we use in seances. There's also other objects such as the trumpet. So this is a cardboard sort of trumpet, nothing too special. Sometimes they're made of aluminium. It's just a coned bit of cardboard that what happens is when the medium is in trance, in a state of trance, preparing for phenomena in the cabinet. So the cabinet is over there, that big like black area, is to contain the energy. It's not a magician's box. It is to contain the energy that is being built up by the physical medium from the sitters. So through spirit contact, through the ectoplasm, will be produced through many different orifices of the body, of the medium, the nose, the mouth, the ears, sometimes under the fingernails, or the belly button. And the ectoplasm comes originally from within inside the body. I've heard the pancreas mixed with other fluids in the body, but also non-physical energies. And this helps then spirit, because it's very light and supple, but also very strong too. And so this rod from the medium's form can then hook on to the trumpet that is on the floor, or sometimes standing up. And through the arm of the ectoplasm, not the actual arm of the medium, but when the ectoplasm is produced, it will form a pole, a tripod, so to speak, and it will form a voice box within a copycat, a clone of the person speaking from once when they were physically alive. And you might think, how are they doing that? My thoughts is that through the Akashic records and the memory of what they sounded like, then they'll produce a voice box, which is very similar. And the end of the ectoplasm, and then holding on to the trumpet, will be then a voice that can be coming out of here. There was another trumpet we had a while back, and it got very lots of stains inside from the ectoplasm. It was hard to take a photo of it, but looking inside, there was all these different marks and stuff where you could see ectoplasm was forming in there, which is very interesting. But it doesn't have to be anything special. You can make it yourself. It's just a piece of cardboard, really, with a few bits of glow-in-the-dark tape on, just to show in the seance where it is at all times. So yeah, even, you know, little bits of that light, it's okay. But when you have a very bright light, even from an LED, it is very, very light. So other things in the seance are such as cable ties, which is a favorite. Now, here's a demonstration of we have different colored ones. We have like a red one and a blue one. And this is to strap down the medium in a chair for a number of reasons. One reason is to stop the medium jerking in their chair and hitting themselves, causing them harm, but also, it's also an important thing for sitters to then know that the medium is being cable tied in there. And most mediums are cable tied in. Some of them are either controlled from the circle leader or the other helper within the circle to have their hands on them the whole time. So they don't always have to be bound in. But if the energy does produce a lot more, then their arms and legs need to be held in place because they're going through so much changes and energy that they can sometimes hit themselves or cause injury. So it's important for them to be in. Now, cable ties are very strong. You cannot get out of cable ties at all. Once you are in, there's no getting out until you cut them out. So to show how strong it is, this is a one that's been cut off, and with the typical sound of a cable tie, is that you cannot, without any force, you cannot get out of this cable tie. Unless you had to go the other way, which is physically impossible when this is on. So give you a demonstration on same one. All cable ties act the same, you don't get any trick ones. The only way to get out of a cable tie is to actually have a tool to then go inside the tooth, which is biting on the jagged edge, to then release. Now you think about it, if a medium is cable tied in, arms and legs, there's no way that they are able to pick that. Even if they were to use their mouth with some sort of screwdriver, which they're all checked anyway in our public seances, there's no way that a medium can get out of those restraints. But that doesn't mean to say that spirit won't stop that happening. If they want to get the medium out, they will. And you know, we have seen that happen before, and we've seen matter through matter, where a cable tie has been attached to the medium, arms and legs, and sometimes they just release them and have actually chucked them out into the middle of the room to show that what is possible. Now that's not physically possible. Once the cable tie is on the person, around their arm, there's no way that's coming off unless you cut it. So the spirit had actually, matter through matter, taken the cable tie out, still intact, with the ends cut off. So this was after one long cable tie, such as this yellow one. This is an end. So you have the female end here and the male end. So this red part is one that's being cut off. So through one, I remember an experience where two cable ties were thrown in the center of the room by the spirit team from a particular medium that works regularly with us here. And the cable tie was still intact, and I think, wow, how is that possible? And you know, spirit asked permission from us first of all, if it was okay to do so. So yeah, cable ties, you know, it's an important thing to be working with, especially with physical mediums. But yeah, here's one here, a cable tie where, you know, it is intact and you cannot, without force, and I'm quite strong, without any force, cannot get that off. That is super on there. So any way to cut that off is with some snips, some cable cutters, and that's what we use. Don't use scissors, because when they're very tight on the body, you're gonna most likely gonna cut your medium, and that's not good. There are cases that has happened before, not in our seances. We have cable cutters, which I'll show you actually. So these are cable cutters, as you can see here. They are cutters that cut cables, very thick cables, and you can easily just cut pieces. So this is really on here. This is the blue one I was showing you earlier, which is a cable tie. Very, you know, they're very strong. Any way to get out of that is to cut. So when the medium is in, arms and legs, we often just cut, and it's very simple just to release. That's any way that a person is going to be released out of this, is through that. So yeah, those are some of the objects. There are other things sometimes involved in the room, such as luminous objects, such as a plaque. So this has got glow in the dark tape on, which is illuminated before, and this allows any spirit to then have physical forms going over the plaque. So in total darkness, through the illumination of the glow-in-the-dark plaque here, you would see then physical forms like hands or you know, shapes and stuff going over that in total darkness. Another way of the new way of working, and not working with physical mediumship and ectoplasm, is working with the new energies. So from the skull experiment, this isn't a good example because we don't have the actual dome, but you can buy domes online anywhere. They're not too expensive. They're just pieces of glass, obviously a hole in the bottom, this closed on the top. And typically you'll have a piece of wood at the bottom with a hole through the center, placed on a table that's raised up a little bit. And just like the cabinet over there contains the energy of the physical medium. Now, when you are sitting in a home circle, all your energies can allow to be put into this glass dome. And this is typically what the skull experiment had done previously in the past, where they had stored the energies in this dome to be used later. So when you're giving energy and it's building up, then all the circle members, say there's five or six people, for example, all the energies were intentionally being put into the dome, which goes underneath through a hole, through a bit of wood, or any type of material, really. I guess wood works best. And it's contained in here. And there's some circles that have used domes and found that they can see flashes and sparks with inside here. Not majorly, but subtly. Just show that there's energy being built up in the dome. So these are some of the equipment and objects that we use. There's also glow-in-the-dark golf balls that we sometimes use in a particular seance, where these are just illuminated and then brought out. So we have actually a black pillowcase with objects put in there so it doesn't produce any light. And then these objects can be brought out when requested. So typically that is most equipment. Also another important one, which I don't have with me, although I am using to record with my video camera here, is a sound recorder. So this is the Zoom H6 handy recorder. This is a bit too much. It's got an illuminated screen, but we have another type which basically is in the room during seances, which we record everything, because if anything valuable was to be heard or made a noise, then we can listen back. And it's important to have a sound recorder with you. You don't have to spend a lot of money. It could just be a cheap sound recorder that has an SD card in there that you can digitally get the information from. But also not just digital, but also cassette stuff. You might find there's voices sometimes or information on the recording that wasn't in the room originally. So that is things such as electronic voice phenomena, EVP. So sound recorder is very important to have inside the seance room, home circles. Have it recording the whole time, because you never know what you're gonna capture. And if you have any doubt in your mind, like an experience that we had when we are sure that we locked a door and took the key out, and at the end of the seance, we found that the key was in the door and the door was wide open, and that was more evidence and a story to be remembered by the circle leader at the time. Was more for their truth and their understanding, but they had so much doubt in their mind, thinking, I'm sure I locked that door. And you can hear on the recording that the door is being locked, and at the end of the seance, the door is opened and the key is in there, because Spirit had given us that experience. And we actually requested, can we like a demonstration of matter through matter? And the typical medium in trance was saying, okay, we'll see what we can do. We'll put on the list. And at the end, was surprised that they had opened the door without any sound. And so no one had that key but the circle leader. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's a bit lengthy because there's lots to explain, as well as the others. But I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you in the other videos.